As a YouTuber that A, spends a lot of time on social media, and B, spends a lot of time looking for and buying used cars, one of the most common misconceptions that I hear with the car market today is that you can't buy a reliable and safe vehicle for a cheap price. I see these comments all the time on TikTok, YouTube, Instagram, and on all sorts of different videos, ones that I make and ones that other people make as well. Or comments like, buying a used $5,000 car is even worse than buying a new car because a $5,000 car is going to have a ton of repair costs. Or things like, there's no such thing as a reliable $10,000 car. In fact, I just heard that comment this week, which actually inspired me to make this video. And all of these comments, as well as dozens of others, are commentary that I've seen with my own two eyes, and they truly could not be further from the truth. And so in today's video, I'm going to be tackling that misconception head on, and we're going to be talking about some reliable, cheap, and below market value vehicles that you can buy in a variety of different price ranges, including sub $20,000, sub $15,000, sub $10,000, and sub $5,000 price ranges for a used vehicle. I'm going to break down some of the best cars that you can purchase in these different price ranges, where you can find them, and why these cars are the best. And I'm going to be giving you examples for minivans, SUVs, and crossovers, as well as sedan and hatchbacks. That way, no matter what type of car you're looking for, your bases are going to be covered. So let's first start off this video by talking about the sub $20,000 price range, because let's face it, if $20,000 is your budget, then the world is your oyster. If you have $20,000 to spend on a used car, it really isn't a matter of which cars you can find, but really a matter of what car you want to buy, because you have a ton of different options to choose from. If a minivan is your style, I'd go with something like the Sienna. The Toyota Sienna is a Toyota, so it's bulletproof and they go forever. Sure, with a sub $20,000 price range, many of these Siennas are going to be over 100,000 miles, but believe it or not, there are actually plenty with well below that. You just have to make sure to look for them. For example, you could get this one, which truthfully, if $20,000 was your out-the-door budget, you would need to negotiate off the top. And while those are getting closer to that $20,000 budget than we'd like, you could also go with something like this. 64,000 miles and has plenty of room for TTNL with a sub $16,000 price point. Don't know how I feel about that push bar, but that's okay. All of these Siennas are cars that you could easily get between 10 and 15 years out of if you take good care of the vehicle and depending on how much you drive, but you could certainly very easily get 5 to 10 years. And whenever it comes to SUVs and crossovers, you still have plenty to choose from. You could choose something like this Hyundai Tucson, this RAV4, you could even go something like this Lexus RX350. And if you felt like you had plenty of choices with crossovers and SUVs, with sedans you have even more. Toyotas, Hyundais, Fords. There are truly too many to name for this video, so instead, I want to talk about some of the ones that you should not buy. And you should avoid buying things like this Audi A5 with over 100,000 miles, this BMW 335i with nearly 100,000 miles, and for the love of God, do not buy this Maserati. When it comes to searching for a sub $20,000 car, it truly is like buying a used car on easy mode. And my best advice to you would be patient, do your due diligence, and know exactly what you want to buy and how much you should expect to pay for that car if you want a below market value deal. Make sure to get a good PPI. This is really going to apply to all of the cars that we're talking about in this video. And whenever it comes to the platforms that you can purchase these cars on, you could go Craigslist, Facebook, Cars.com. You could even potentially buy directly from a dealership, though you aren't going to get the best deal with that avenue. Now on to the $15,000 price category. For minivans, the $15,000 price category does get a bit tougher, and you do either have to go with a different brand than the Toyota Sienna, or you have to accept that you're going to have to get an older one. Now, admittedly, there are a lot of Dodge Grand Caravans for $15,000 or less, like this 2018 with 74,650 miles, or this 2019 with 105,000 miles for just under 15 grand. But over a Dodge Grand Caravan, I'd choose a Honda Odyssey. A bit older than a Dodge Grand Caravan, but quite a bit more reliable. But truthfully, even in this price range, I would still choose a Toyota Sienna. A sub $15,000 Toyota Sienna is quite a bit harder to find than one in that $20,000 price range. The $5,000 here can make a big difference. So if you're looking for a Toyota Sienna for under 15 grand, I would definitely look at Facebook and I would skip out on dealerships and cars.com altogether. And while these Toyota Siennas in this price range are going to be a little bit older and higher mileage, they are still, in my opinion, really solid buys. For example, this 2011 Sienna with 120,000 miles, this car is priced at $12,500. This leaves you some money for taxes and it's a killer deal. Now, when it comes to SUVs and crossovers, I would buy something like a 2011 Toyota Highlander all day long with 13,000 miles. This car is clean. It also comes fully loaded since it's a limited. The best part is there are a number of Highlanders in this price range. A RAV4 is also a great buy in this price range, like this 2017 with under 100,000 100,000 miles. And this Honda CR-V is also a good buy. Under 100,000 miles, a 2015, it looks great and it leaves money for taxes at a price of $12,900. And for sedans, this is where, again, you have quite a lot of options available to you. We have Toyota Corollas, a 2019 really nice Hyundai Sonata. You could even get a Lexus for under 15 grand, like this one here. When we start getting into the realm of $15,000 cars, this is where you do end up getting a much better bang for your buck going private party. Facebook is hands down my method of choice whenever it comes to buying vehicles private party, and if you are somebody who is worried about buying a used car in this price range, you could always lower the price of the car that you're looking for and put that additional funds towards something like an extended warranty. But truthfully, instead of doing that, I would opt out of the warranty altogether and I would just go with a used Toyota. That kinda is your warranty. And the great part is, a Toyota Highlander and a Toyota Corolla are really great cars. Not only will they get you where you need to go for a long period of time, but they also look good too, especially the Highlander. And truthfully, whenever we're talking about bang for your buck, reliability, and safety, I think that there are a few cars in this price range that beat the Highlander. The thing that many people get wrong about used cars is that they look at mileage equally across different makes and models. But the thing is that mileage means very different things depending on the type of car that we're looking at. Mileage on a Toyota is different than mileage on a Kia, is different than on a Maserati or a Mercedes or a Lexus. You have to look at mileage in the context of the car that you're looking at. So buying a Highlander for 11 grand that has over 100k miles, that is a solid buy, even though it is relatively high mileage. Now on to the $10,000 price range. Now with this price range, we are starting to get in more challenging territory, and this is specifically true again with the minivan. When it comes to finding a minivan in this price range, hands down the easiest one that you'll be able to find will be that Dodge Grand Caravan. You can find plenty of these for under 10 grand, and while I'm not a huge fan of this vehicle, I do know many people who have them and have really enjoyed them, so I feel like this car at least has to get an honorable mention. Like this 2018 with 106,000 miles. And while this is a really good deal for 8 grand, I would probably still opt into something like a Toyota Sienna. This one here is clean title, it does have 136,000 miles, but it's a 14 and it's priced at $8,500. This to me is a much better buy than a Dodge Grand Caravan. It has better reliability, it's a below market value deal, it all around I think is a really solid buy for the price. For SUVs and crossovers, something like a 2012 Ford Escape 4-cylinder could be an excellent purchase. Now I specify 2012 because in 2013 the Ford Escape changed the engine and these cars became significantly less reliable. So if you buy a Ford Escape, it needs to be a 2012 year model or older. And the reason why I specify a 4-cylinder is because the V6s are harder to work on and thus they're more expensive to repair. So anything between a 2008 and a 2012 Ford Escape could be a solid purchase. For example, this 2012 Escape is one I'd buy in a heartbeat. I also think an older Honda CR-V is a great buy, like this one here. And while I may get flack for this one, this is a hill that I will happily die on, and I wholeheartedly think that one of the best cars and SUVs that you can buy for sub $10,000 is the Hyundai Tucson. I have one, and whenever I was tasked with helping my sister buy a sub $10,000 SUV last year, a Hyundai Tucson is exactly what I chose. These cars are ones you can buy for a great price, what you get for that price is great, and the reliability is solid. And well, whenever it comes to sedans in this price range, we again have some pretty decent options. Something like a Hyundai Sonata. This is an older but relatively low mileage Honda Fit. The Fit is an excellent car, though I know not really a sedan. You could even get a solid Toyota Corolla for under 10 grand as well, like this 2011, or a Yaris, which is an excellent choice. This one is for sale for $8,500 and it's a newer model. Now, like I mentioned a moment ago, I believe that once we start getting in that $10,000 range and below, buying private party is hands down going to be the best method to go after in order to find these great deals and these great cars for a cheap price. And truthfully, my best piece of advice for buying cars in this price range is to know exactly what you want, know exactly what you want to pay, and have cash ready to go so that you can jump on deals as soon as they pop up. Good deals get sold, and one of my methods that I always use in order to get the best deal possible is to message sellers that are selling cars and tell them, hey, would you take X amount of dollars? I can come right now, or I can come tomorrow morning. I can come within the next 24 hours. And the ability to get a sale within 24 hours is oftentimes incentivizing to that person that they'll not only say yes, but they will give me a discount. This is crucial because in this price range, buying a car can become very competitive, and if you don't jump on a deal fast enough, it will get sold to someone else. Now on to the hardest level of them all, the sub $5,000 car, and this is truthfully my bread and butter because this is the type of car that I buy most often. On to minivans. Now, whenever you look for minivans in the sub $5,000 category, you are going to find a ton of them that have rolled back mileage, rebuild titles, and just really aren't good vehicles. So doing a good PPI and running the Carfax on these vehicles is going to be crucial. And at sub $5,000, while a Toyota Sienna isn't going to be the prettiest car that you can purchase, I do think that it's one of the better ones. Like this one right here, for example. I also really like the Mazda 5. I own one and this car has been great. I don't know that I would buy it over a Sienna, but I do think it's a solid choice. And you could also go with that Grand Caravan, but I do think that once we get into the realm of sub $5,000, even Grand Caravans start to become a bit more sketchy. So I would, in this scenario, opt for a Toyota or a newer Mazda 5. Now on to SUVs and crossovers. You can find the same Ford Escape that I mentioned earlier, so a 4-cylinder, 2012 or older, for under $5,000. Though they are a bit more higher mileage, this one is a great example of that. A higher mileage, older RAV4 is also an excellent buy. And when it comes to sedans or hatchbacks, compact cars, this is truly where my bread and butter lies because these types of cars specifically are what I buy most often. One of my top choices is a Mazda 3. I think that these cars are excellent and there are a variety of different ones to choose from. A Mazda 2 is another solid choice, though they are harder to find for sub $5,000 than a Mazda 3. An older Honda Fit is something I'd buy all day. But truthfully, I always tell people that if I had to buy myself the cheapest car as possible that would be the most reliable vehicle to drive, there is one choice that I would choose over every other vehicle out there, and that is a Toyota Yaris. This one right here is a gem, but there are others out there that are also under $5,000 as well, though I must admit that this one here is abnormally nice. But it is priced for under $5,000, which goes to show that there are plenty of these types of cars out there, for even cheaper and maybe in a little bit worse condition. Of all the vehicles that I own, from my Hyundais, Fords, Mazdas, Kias, and everything in between, my Toyota Yaris have by far been the most reliable vehicles in my fleet. These cars are absolutely bulletproof. They never have any issues, and when they do, they are pretty cheap to fix because the parts are easy to install and they're readily available. These cars are incredible and they last, and truly, if I had to buy a budget vehicle for myself or somebody close to me, Toyota Yaris is what I would opt into. I always say that renting your car out on Turo is sort of like the litmus test of vehicle reliability because your Turo guests are going to abuse your car way more than you'll ever abuse it. So you really do get to see which cars stand the test of time. And Toyota has just been incredible. And the Yaris specifically has just been so bulletproof. I will be a stan of those cars for the rest of my life because they have been incredibly reliable and just really great performers. Now, when it comes to buying these sub $5,000 cars, really everything that I've talked about in this video is going to apply. Making sure you know what you want to buy, what you should expect to pay, having cash in hand, jumping on the deal as soon as you see it. But one thing that I think is very specific to these sub $5,000 cars is the fact that once you start getting into these ultra cheap cars, the quality of vehicle listing is going to go down. And while many people view this as a red flag, I actually view it as a green flag. If you look on Facebook and you see that there's a car that has little to no description, the photos are horrible, there's only one or two pictures there, the seller just obviously didn't put a lot of effort into the car, this should be an indicator that this seller is lazy and they're not wanting to put the work into actually getting top dollar for that vehicle, and thus they're going to settle for less. Some of the best deals that I've had over the years have been cars that have just been really ill prepared to be sold. They're dirty, they need to be cleaned, the listing sucked. And again, it kind of goes back to the fact that the seller really didn't want to put the work into getting as much money out of the deal as possible. And this means that you can come in, negotiate, and really get that car for a great deal. Now, the point of this video is to really drive home the fact that reliable, safe cars exist in every single price range. It doesn't matter if your price range is 0 to 5,000 or 0 to 20,000. And the safety and reliability of a vehicle has far less to do with the amount that you spend on the car or even the year of that vehicle, and instead it has so much more to do with the type of vehicle that you purchase. And truthfully, all of the cars that I talked about in this video are cars I wouldn't hesitate to buy myself. In fact, many of them are ones that I have purchased. If you want to learn my exact process of how I buy cheap, reliable cars for the sake of listing these vehicles out on Turo, remember that I do have a course, the Car Sharing Masterclass, where we teach you everything that you need to know about running and scaling a car sharing fleet with the exact same business model that I use, which is basically built on the idea of buying cheap, reliable, everyday cars that people can use for a budget price. You can use the code OFFER100 to get $100 off that course. The link is down in the description below. And like always, you guys, I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, comments, if you have anything to add, I would love to hear it, so make sure to leave a comment down below. And while you guys are at it, make sure to hit the like button, hit that subscribe button, and hit the notification bell, and I will see you guys in the next video.